And when we landed at Houston Airport, we came out of the plane and we walked on the bridge. As soon as I stepped foot on Houston Airport, I heard the voice. I think this angel followed me, you know. He said, "This city will be destroyed by a massive flood." I thought, oh no. I don't know anything about the history about Houston, you know. So while we were traveling from the airport to the city of Houston, the driver, the wonderful pastor, minister of God who picked us, was talking with Pastor Joe Sweet. And he mentioned something about there was a great flood in the city. I was still too occupied in my mind about what encounters that I had. I didn't quite pay attention to what both of them was talking about. But I just faintly heard the word flood. Okay, but when I got into the hotel room, I Googled. Thank God for Googled, you know. You've got the whole world in your hands. Are you old enough to know that song?
Yes.
Okay. So now Google is like that. So when I Googled, there was records of history of massive flooding in Houston. Now, it didn't make me very pleasant, you know. I don't know why, this time, these things really bothered me very much. It has never bothered me in the past. Never. I just didn't know why it bothered me so much. Until 2 days later, when I saw in the news, the nation, the highest legislation in the country, has passed the same-sex marriage law. Then I understood why. See, your judges are not just Supreme Court judges, but are judges of the land. And what they pronounce, they have put a curse on their own country. And by opening a floodgate. So first was the judges of the land. Second was the king of the land. As soon as the Supreme Court passed the bill, President Obama went on the air to second and to champion the cause of the passing of the bill. And the whole White House was lighted up in the rainbow colors of the LGBT community. You know, the White House is the King's house. It's supposed to be the representation before God. And what are they showing to God? It's like showing the fist sign, you know. I'm sorry to say that, but that's exactly what you have done. You show the finger sign to God by protracting the rainbow colors on the White House. That is gross sin. Gross sin. When I saw all this, then I understood why the Lord spoke 3 times in succession, which means things will come speedily. Speedily. Destruction will come speedily. So all your prayers can save you and your family. But that which has been determined upon the nation will come. Like what Brother Neville has been sharing these past 3 days about things that have been determined. Like what Daniel the prophet interpreted the dream that Nebuchadnezzar saw. He said, the thing has been decreed by the watchers. Decreed means done, passed. It will certainly come to pass. So, and then I still didn't give up, you know. I still didn't give up.